Welcome to the .NET MAUI Time Picker Control Tutorial. The Syncfusion .NET MAUI Time Picker allows you to select a time easily. In this video, I will demonstrate how to add a Syncfusion .NET MAUI Time Picker control to a .NET MAUI project and show you how to customize the time picker's height, width, text on the validation buttons, the time format, programmatically select a time, and add a header and footer. Before you begin, ensure you have installed the latest version of Visual Studio 2022 with the required .NET MAUI workload. You should also have one of the .NET SDKs installed on your machine. After installing the necessary tools, I launch Visual Studio 2022 and click Create a New Project from the dashboard. From the list of project templates, I select the .NET MAUI application. Then I give the project name and location. I create a project with the .NET 7.0 framework. Now the default application is ready to use. Before moving forward, let me take a quick detour to set up the application's environment. Here, I select the Android emulators from this list to see the output in the Pixel 5 emulator. After selecting the emulator, I'll run the application to show you the default output. The application compiles the default code, so let's wait for a few seconds. Now, the application's home page is displayed. Next, I'll show you how to incorporate the Syncfusion MAUI Time Picker control into this application. First, I need to install the Syncfusion MAUI Picker NuGet package. So, I open the NuGet package manager and switch to the Browse tab. I search for the Syncfusion MAUI Picker package and select it to install in my project. Once the package is installed, I need to register the handler for the Syncfusion core to map the cross-platform control API to the native view API. I open the MAUI program CS file and add the Syncfusion MAUI core hosting namespace. Then, I register the Syncfusion core handler by adding the configure Syncfusion core method. Registering a trial license key is necessary to use the Syncfusion MAUI controls. So I open the AppSAML CS file and add the register license method with the trial license key. To find out how to generate a trial license key, refer to the instructions provided in the description below. Next, I navigate to the main page XAML to initialize the control. I remove the default code from the content page section and import the Syncfusion MAUI Picker namespace. I initialize the Time Picker control. Now I will run the application. Look here, the Time Picker is displayed in the format of hours, minutes, and seconds, and it automatically selects the current time. You can also manually select a time from the Time Picker. To customize the UI, I load the Time Picker control inside a border element. Then, set its height request to 400 and width request to 350. Now, as you can see, the control is displayed at the center of the screen and its size has been adjusted. To programmatically select a time, I set the selected time property to the appropriate time in the hours, minutes, seconds format. By default, its value is the current time. Looking at it now, the specified time has been selected. Now let me show you how to add a header and footer for the time picker. To display a header, I define the header view property. Then I add a picker header view element and set the text to select a time and the height to 40. Observe that the header is displayed at the top of the time picker. Next, to display a footer, define the footer view property. Then, add a picker footer view element and set its height to 40. Look here at the bottom of the time picker, OK and cancel validation buttons are displayed. To customize the validation button text, set the OK button text to yes and the cancel button text to no. Now you can see the OK button text changed to yes, and the cancel button text changed to no. Finally, I will show you how to customize the time format of the time picker. For example, if you want to display only the hour and minute with the meridian, you can change the format by setting the format property to hour minute meridian. Note that different formats are available. The default format is hours, minutes, and seconds. Now you can see that the time picker is displayed in the specified format. In this video, I have demonstrated how to create a .NET MAUI application and incorporate a Syncfusion time picker control. I showed you how to customize the time picker's size, programmatically select a time, add a header and footer, customize the text of the validation buttons, and customize the time format. To learn more about the time picker's features, you can check the documentation link provided in the description below. I have also included a link in the description to check if you qualify for our community license, which gives you a free license key for our entire .NET MAUI control suite. If you found this video useful, don't forget to click the like button and subscribe to our channel to watch more videos like this. Thanks for watching.